5.5-hour flight, and so the girls that were there, if I had to guess, like six of us, roughly, that were all mostly on the same flight, and we went to drop off our luggage because check-in was at 4, so we couldn't check in yet, but we had a reservation at the spa in the Caesars Hotel. I'm sorry, Caesars Palace. So we dropped off our luggage with the bellhops and took our little ticket and then went over to the spa. And the spa was really funny. It was amazing, but it was funny. So we get there, they give us a tour. It's beautiful. It's like, I almost felt like not worthy of being there. So we get lockers, put ourselves in the lockers, and then there's a pool. And so we go in the pool. Most of us didn't bring bathing suits, and they gave us these like disposable bathing suits. We're not even gonna go into that. That was funny. So we go in, we got there around 2, so we had like an hour to kill while we're in the pool. The fire alarm goes off, and we're like, no shot. Like, there's no way. It was either go out in disposable bathing suits or go out with the rope they gave you in 105 degrees. We're kind of like, so what do we do here? And then immediately they come on the like intercom and they're like, we're just testing it. Like, you're fine. Everybody stay calm. And we're like, they close at 4. So we're like, why couldn't you just test it at 4 o'clock? Like, people are getting massages and are in the pool, and the alarm was loud. And then, you know, those white lights that flash. And so the alarm itself turned off after a few minutes, but the white lights, they were blinking for I think like 30 or 40 minutes while we were in the pool, so that was kind of annoying. Whatever. They had snacks there, water, seltzer, all the things. So then we get out of the pool at 3:55, we go into the waiting area lounge, and then they call us one by one. We all went at the same time in individual rooms, but we all went at the same time. So I got a 50-minute Swedish massage, I think we all did, and it was, guys, well, it was only the second massage of my life, but it was the best massage of my life. If you've never had a massage, like an actual one at a spa, go do it. Do yourself a favor. The table was heated. So, like, you come out of the pool, you're a little cold, you lay on the table, and it's heated. It felt so good. I was, like, falling asleep. My goodness, my stomach. I'm so hungry. I'm sorry. So, it was amazing. They always ask you, like, how do you like the pressure or whatever. I always say medium because I'm really not the biggest fan of massages. Usually they kind of hurt. And she could tell because she was like, my gosh, like, your body's so tense and like tight, because I told her my focus area would be like my shoulder and my back because I know I carry a lot of tension there. And she was like, yeah, you do. And I was like, girl, I know. I was like, this is only my second massage, and my last one was like 3 years ago, so. But whatever, it was amazing. Background noise, the lighting was super dim. So good. They even like massage your scalp a little bit and like the back of your neck. Amazing. So we all walked out one by one, just like in a trance, and just like looked at each other. We were like, whoa. So that was amazing. So then we left and we went to go check into our rooms. So these hotels are huge. Caesar's Palace literally has towers. And so we had three rooms for 13 girls, and it was like 3 to a room, and one of them had 4. The one with the bride, it was the bride, her sister, her future sister-in-law, and her cousin, the 4 of them, and then the rest of us like split up. And of course, the bride and them were in a completely opposite tower than we were. It was fine, it worked out, but it was a hike to get there, to their tower. It took like 5 minutes, maybe a little more, to walk to their room, but it was fine, we made it work. And then the rest of us were like a floor apart. So we check into our rooms. It's super nice. And what did we do by that point? It was already 4 something, so we had to get ready for dinner. Yeah, so we went in and we all showered. And we went Frank Sinatra themed restaurant, and they're playing all his, you know, his music is the background music. So Sinatra reminds me of my grandpa, and so it just, that was really like cozy and nostalgic for me. We all got one drink and then ordered dinner. I got a lasagna bolognese in a little pot. I'll try to remember to put some pictures up. It was delicious, and you could tell that the quality of the food was so good. And we all said the same thing, because like I was eating pasta. Pasta usually makes me kind of bloated and whatever. I ate most of it and I felt fine. I felt great. And we all kind of noticed that. So the quality of the food was fantastic. And we were there. Our reservation was at 8. I think we left probably by 10 or so. And then we went outside the hotel, like in the hallway or in the outside of the restaurant, took like a group picture. It was really cute. And then we all went back to the hotel, because our hotel, because we were having a pajama and like wine night, just because people were coming at different times and we all had traveled and it was a long day. And so the first night was going to be more chill. Before I actually ended up showering, this is what I forgot, before I showered, me and my friend Rachel, we went to the bride's room, and some of the girls like took her away and like entertained her for like an hour, and we went with our sister and decorated the room, so put things up on the walls, on the ceilings. We had a little letter board that we wrote like the date of our wedding. They bought cupcakes and cookies and brownies and like little disco ball cups. The theme of our bachelorette was like Barbie, so pink and Barbie themed things. We had little disco ball cups, props for like a photo station. It was really cute, like it came out really, really cute. Balloons. So after dinner we all put our pink pajamas on and went to the bride's room and just took a bunch of pictures, had snacks. There were a bunch of bottles. It wasn't really, it was champagne, but it was like rosé champagne, like sparkling rosé. I only had a little bit, most of us only really had a little bit, just because I personally, I'll say, like I didn't drink too much the whole trip, just because, we'll get into the heat in a second. It was the heat, and also, I hung over really easily these days, and my hangovers don't feel great, so I wanted to be fully present and like enjoy the whole trip and not be miserable. So I drank like a little bit, you know. I still drank, but I wasn't like knocking him back, you know. Not that there's anything wrong with that, that was just my personal opinion. And let me just say, while we're on the subject, I think a lot of you thought that like I was not gonna enjoy this trip, or I was trying not to enjoy it. Like, I saw comments on my last video being like, girl, loosen up, like you're going to Vegas. Like, maybe it came across that way, and if it did, I apologize. I had so much fun. I was just worried about the heat and said that I really wasn't gonna drink a lot. That's it. I'm one of those cheesy people. It's like, I don't need alcohol to have fun, but it's true. I actually have less fun when I'm drunk, just from past experiences. Trust me, I've had many experiences in my past. It's just personal preference, but I had a great time. Okay, just put that out there. I'm not a grandma yet, guys. Anyway, so yeah, I also, rosé is not my favorite, just for like tummy reasons. My tummy does not enjoy it, but I had some, had lots of snacks, put cookies in front of me, I'm gonna eat them. We took pictures. She just had so much fun, music on, dancing a little bit. And then I think I and me and my other friends cut out at, I think like 12:30, 1 o'clock. We were like, all right, we're gonna start to get ready for bed, because the next 2 days were gonna be like marathon days. We had so much planned. We had brunch the next day at noon, so we were like, and we were also tired. I can't sleep on planes really, so you know, we were kind of just like, yeah, we're gonna go get ready for bed. Some of the girls stayed and continued dancing and whatever, which was great. I'm glad they stayed with her and prolonged the night. We went to bed around 12:31. And I slept like a baby. It was those blackout curtains in the hotel. Game changer. Saturday brunch. We went, it was in the Powers Hotel. It was called bottomless. Bottomless is like you're in bed by 7 p.m. sort of thing, you know? So, we went, it was 14 of us actually, because the bride's future mother-in-law was there. She was in the area, so she came to brunch with us, which was lovely. And I got Eggs Benedict, and I ordered a sangria, but they brought me like a lemon drop sort of drink. And I was gonna give it back and like get the sangria, but then I tasted it and it was good, so I just kept it. The food was so good. The Paris Hotel is literally like they designed the inside of it to look like the streets of Paris. And even the ceiling is painted like a sky. It's beautiful. We kind of got lost in there looking for the restaurant, so we got to walk around it a little bit, and it was beautiful. We also ordered for the table this big, it was a big jug that looked like a disco ball, and they essentially put like a alcoholic punch in there. I was like, so it's like jungle juice, okay. And it was so good. It had fresh fruit, a bunch of ice, and whatever the drink was. It was so good. It was better than my drink, actually. So I had some of that. Then we were going to explore the strip and like walk around, and we were like, nope, can't do it. It was abrasively hot. Like the people that say like, oh, you're not gonna feel it as much because it's dry heat. I understand, like, yes, there's truth to that, but you still feel it. It was like after 4 or 5 minutes of walking in it, it was like hard to breathe. Like your chest gets really like tight. So it was the bride. We let the bride make the decision. Cause she was like, do you guys want to walk around? Do you want to go to the pool at the hotel? And we were like, well, what do you want to do? And she was wearing like a long dress too. And she was like, nah, let's go to the pool. So we went, to like a little mall nearby on the strip, bought some like alcohol for the room and just like for later, and bought a lot of water and brought it back to our hotel. Changed really quick, and then we all went down to the pool, Caesar's pool. There's like multiple pools, and like we went to Neptune's pool, and it's just so beautiful. And the sun is definitely different there, because like I got sun, but I thought for sure we were all gonna burn because of how hot it felt the whole trip. Not one of us got a sunburn. Even the guys, I think none of them got a sunburn either. So that was really cool and surprising, because it feels like you're burning, but we didn't burn. So we were in the pool for, I don't know, an hour and a half, maybe, if I had to guess. And then eventually we all went upstairs to get ready for the night. So this was such a fun night. We had a surprise for the bride and groom. We all rented a party bus for them. It was 30 of us. The men were there as well, the groom and the groomsmen, but we were completely separate except for the nighttime activity, like this night primarily. So we didn't see them until this night. They came to our hotel and the party bus picked us up. So we kind of were like, okay guys, we have to go downstairs and take some pictures. And then we were gonna, the party bus was gonna pull up, and we were like, surprise, by the way, this is for us. So the party bus drove us around from 7:30 to 9:30, I believe. Drove us around, played music for 2 hours. We took pictures. It was so fun. And we all, most of us, all went to college together, so we all know each other. So it wasn't like weird, you know, like everybody was friends already. So it was just fun. It was a really good time. And yeah, so we danced. It was so hot in that bus, but we danced, had some drinks. It was fun. Then they let us off. Then we were going to Omnia. Nope, that's wrong. Omnia was the next day. What club was this? Club Live. We went to Live. At night, we had a table. We had two tables, one for the boys, one for the girls. The boys have to pay more, so they sat a little, they actually had a nicer table than we did, because boys, it's more expensive for men. And we had our own little table, so they brought out, like, you know, the bottle girls bring out the bottles and the lights and the sparklers, and they brought out a big sign that said congratulations and like pictures of my friend, and it was really cool. She loves it. Like, she loves clubs and like going out in the nightlife. That's like her thing. So she felt super special and super happy, and that's all, that's the point, right? And so it was fun. So we were dancing in our little corner doing the things, and then at like 2 a.m. I believe, no, that's a lie, 1 p.m. 1 a.m. Tiesto came on, DJ. Tiesto was there and played a set, and so we went over to the boys' table and like stayed with them for the rest of the night, pretty much, because they also had a better view of Tiesto and the dance floor. So we were up on the balcony, so we were just dancing, you know, all the songs that we know, and it was just a good time. Took pictures, it was fun. So we made it to 2:30 that night. The main group of us that, like, you know, don't drink and like too much, we made it to 2:30, and then we Ubered back to our motel, went to sleep, and I think the rest of them were out until like 5 a.m. I was like, God bless, I'm glad you guys had fun. So that was really fun. I loved that little black dress I showed you guys in my Pack With Me video. I'm obsessed with it. I want to wear it to every occasion. I felt really pretty in it. So, and it was comfortable. And yeah, we love a little staple black dress. Anyway, so that was Saturday. Sunday, woke up, we're all tired. We had to be at the Encore Hotel for the Encore pool party. It's on their rooftop, they have a big pool. And the Chainsmokers were playing. The Chainsmokers are DJs now, in case you didn't know. I didn't know that. Or maybe I did, but I like forgot. I don't know. They were playing. So we got there around like 1 p.m. We're supposed to be there at 12. We got there at 1 p.m. Everybody was moving a little slow the next morning. And mind you, we're like, I had 2 liquid IVs a day, I think, on top of regular water. And I think that's what like saved me, because I felt fine the whole trip. I never felt close to fainting. I never felt hungover. Like, I also didn't drink a lot, but you know what I mean? Like, I was just, I was really scared about the fainting thing, and I was fine. So, love those now. I'm a big fan. So we got to the Encore pool party, and we got there at 1. I don't think the Chainsmokers came on until 3. And we got a table. They brought us, I'm not a big tequila drinker, so that's also another reason why I didn't really drink a lot, but I had some tequila and pineapple juice and a lot of water. My one thing I'm gonna vent about, I think it's criminal that people were passing out, like, because of the heat, and also people are drinking. You would, like, I think the hotel should be dropping bottles of water for free for everybody. Do you want to guess how much a bottle of Fiji water was at this place? One bottle of Fiji was $31. Also, why 31? We couldn't make it 30. But also, why 30? I think that's criminal. I don't know how people in good conscience can run a business like that with people fainting left and right. Anyway, that just annoyed me. I was, most of the trip, I was like taking ice and letting it melt into water and then just drinking it. But that was the hottest day, and we got to our table and we did have an umbrella, but the way the sun was hitting, there was no shade. So we were like, even the bride was like, whoa, like, what are we gonna do? Like, we're in trouble here. So we all went in the pool. There were like hundreds of people in that pool, and it was probably gross. Didn't care. Went right into the pool. And that's where I was most of the day. You could not be out of the water, so you'd bring my drink in the pool. Chainsmokers came on at 3. And they were good. It was fun. We couldn't really see them from the pool, but when we were leaving, they were still playing. And so I got a good video of them and a good picture of them. So yeah, that was fun. That was fun. What else? So yeah, we stayed until like 4:30-ish, and then half of us, or no, we had closer to 5, half of us went back and like started showering and getting ready, because we were going to the Magic Mike show. The girls were, obviously, we weren't with the guys. So Magic Mike was at 7:30. We got there at 7:35, but luckily, like, we got there right on time. It was perfect. I forget what hotel this was at, but it was like 10-15 minutes from our hotel. Magic Mike was, it was good. Some of it was a lot, but it was good. goes, but it's not, you're not like shoving money in their underwear, you know what I mean? Like, it's tasteful. I don't know. I enjoyed it though. Like, I will say, sexiness aside and whatever, they are very talented. I think all of them are aspiring performers. Like, there were bios for some of them on the website, some of them were on The Voice. Like, they're trying to make it, you know, so this is like a stepping stone for them, and they're very talented. There was also a woman who was part of the show, and they did this like aerial trapeze number that was breathtaking. It was beautiful. But they do come around and give certain people lap dances. No, I did not get one, but from what I saw, they're very like, it's all about consent. They ask you permission. And we heard one of the dancers like asking this other girl, because she was getting like an actual lap dance. He was like, you know, can I do this? Can I do this? Are you comfortable with this? Like, blah, blah, blah. You know, like, they were nice. They were friendly. They danced with our bride a little bit. Nothing like super inappropriate. They like twirled her at one point, slow danced with her, dipped her. I think one guy maybe got a little frisky, but like, it was fine. My friend Jen, if you're watching this, I know you watch my videos, forgive me, I have to tell this story. One of my friends was sitting right directly to my left. There was this dancer who, he was a big, big muscular dude, ponytail, beard, like just rugged looking. And she was like, oh, he's kind of scary. 2 seconds later, this man came over to her and like kind of got on top of her, and she was laughing, but she screamed in his face or in his ear, and he kind of pulled back and was, he kind of looked at her, but he was laughing, and he was like, are you okay? A video of it. It's so funny. It's so funny. Anyway, it was good. Is it like totally my thing? No, but I enjoyed it. It was fun. We were laughing. We were clapping. We were dancing with them. Like, it was cool. It was fun. I had a nice table in front of me though, so that protected me from the men coming up to me. But again, they were super nice and beautiful, beautiful men. And it was great. It was so much fun. We all got a drink as well. It was fun too. It was like a 90-minute show, so an hour and a half. So much fun. I'm so glad I went. Then we went back to our hotel, and then we were going to another club. So by this point, we were all like zombies. Zombies. Pool party during the day, then dinner, then Magic Mike, then a club. Like, we didn't get to the club until like close to midnight, but this hotel, this club was in our hotel, it's Omnia, which I believe is the number one club in the country from what I hear. And I can see why. It's beautiful in there and it's huge. There's like different rooms and different bars. It's beautiful. But yeah, we were like zombies at that point, and we had to be up at 8 a.m. to go to the airport. So we stayed for a bit, and then little by little, we all started to trickle and go to bed. Trickle off to bed is what I meant. And we ran into the boys there. The boys were there as well, which we knew they were gonna probably come. So we ran into them as well. Some of them, not all of them, were there. And that was it. And then went to our room little by little. I forget what time I went to bed. But I didn't even get a drink. I didn't get a drink in Omnia because, like, absurd. Vegas, just in general, it's so expensive. One of the drinks, it was like maybe a drink like this big, it was like 50, 60 bucks for one. And I was like, why am I gonna pay money to drink something and then go straight to bed? Like, what's the point, you know? So I just was there, this bumping and a little dancing, took a couple pictures. That was our pink night, so we were all in pink, super cute. And then we went to bed. And we all managed to get up on time. The bride was up on time. I was so proud. We got to the airport, got some food. Our flight got delayed like 30, 40 minutes. Not horrible. And I landed at 8 p.m. And my mom and my stepdad picked me up with Luna in the car. And that was it. And then I went right to work the next day. Not this time of year. Sponsoring this video. I hope that you guys enjoyed it. Make sure to check out the link to their earbuds below.